Why do famous brands destroy their unsold goods? The brands and fashion industry is often cited as one of the world's worst polluters, but destroying usable goods altogether in an effort to preserve the status is perhaps the dirtiest secret ever about the industry. Many prestigious brands resort to destroying their unsold products regardless of their manufacturing cost. Why is that? And why don't these companies donate the surplus to charitable foundations or at least put them up for sale at half the price? We will know all of that in this video. Why do world-famous brands destroy their surplus products? In 2017, British luxury brand Burberry generated $3.6 billion in revenue and destroyed $36.8 million in its merchandise. And in July 2018, the brand admitted in its annual report that destroying merchandise was just part of its strategy to maintain its premium reputation. This wasn't good news for shoppers. They reacted to the news and expressed their outrage at the global brand for its wastefulness. Meanwhile, members of parliament called on the British government to suppress this practice. Due to the protests, the famous Burberry brand announced that it would no longer destroy its surplus products. However, Burberry is not the only company to use this practice to rot its surplus products. Many high-end brands like Nike and Louis Vuitton follow suit. Well-known brands strive to preserve the scarcity and exclusivity of their product by destroying the surplus. In a report published by a Danish TV station in 2017, it revealed that the global fashion company H&M has burned 60 tons of its unsold luxury new clothes since 2013. In May 2018, Richemont, owner of the Cartier, Piaget, and Baume & Mercier jewelry and watch brands, admitted that in an effort to keep its products out of the hands of unauthorized sellers, they had destroyed $563 million worth of luxury watches. The answer to the adoption by the companies of well-known brands and brands of surplus destruction method can be simplified as related to quantity and short fashion cycles due to the internet and fast fashion. There is a growing drive to introduce new products to the market, which pushes companies to get rid of previous models to make room for new models to compete with others. Why isn't clothes recycled instead of burned? An option that many people familiar with this practice find better for the fate of luxury clothing than ending up with a pile of ashes and smoke. But for international fashion houses and different brands, this option is more expensive than simply burning it and disposing of it. The process of recycling clothes means mixing types of fabrics such as polyester and cotton, which makes recycling options very limited. Additionally, before recycling, buttons and zippers must be removed, and this requires manual labor associated with an additional cost. Destruction is often cheaper than the whole process. As for the reason for not donating this surplus commodity, it is related to the policy of some poverty-stricken countries, which ban imports from the West because this suppresses the local textile industry and their own traditional clothes. In the end, this practice is not only related to luxury clothing and fashion, but rather is an approach followed by many famous companies, including electrical appliances, jewelry, watches, luxury leather bags, shoes, and even